Hello everyone. In this video, we'll discuss Python program for BubbleSort. Okay. BubbleSort. Okay. So BubbleSort is a simple sorting algorithm. Okay. That works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are not in proper order. Okay, this is very simple sorting algorithm. Okay, works by repeatedly swapping. Repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are not in correct order. If they are in wrong order. So let us discuss some example. Okay, so 51428, so this is the example I have taken from some web source. Okay, this is not my own example. So 51428. Okay, so I want to sort this particular sequence or array. I want to sort this one. Okay, so we'll go for first pass. I'll explain what is this first pass. We have the number 51428. First, let me compare 5 and 1. Okay. 5 is greater than 1, so it should be swapped. Okay, it should be swapped. So I'm getting 1 5 4 2 8. Okay, if you want, you can put brackets. This is the sequence. Okay, that's why I'm putting bracket. Next one, 15428. So this time I'm just considering the next two numbers, 5 and 4. Again, 5 is greater than 4, it's not in the correct order. So we are just swapping 1 4 5 2 8. Next time, 1 4 5 2 8. I'm just comparing the next two numbers, 5 and 2. Obviously, 5 is greater than 2. So what we are doing? We are just swapping 1 4 2 5 8. Okay. Next, 1 4 2 5 8. So we are comparing the next two numbers, 5 and 8. Okay, so they are in the correct order, so no swapping is required. Okay, 1 4 2 5 8. You just write the comment. They are in the correct order. Okay, hence no swapping. Hence no swapping. But if you see, after this particular pass, you just see it is again not swapped. 1 4 2 5 8, you just see 4 is greater than 2. okay, it's not swap. So this should be the input of the first pass. Whatever we have did in the first pass, we have to repeat. Okay, so let me go for the second pass. Okay, 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Let me just check the first two numbers. Okay, so 1 is less than 4, they are in the correct order, so no swap. 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Okay, next time 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Let me compare the next two numbers. 4 is greater than 2, so swapping is required. Okay, so 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Next two numbers. I'm going to compare 4 and 5. They are in the proper order, so no swapping. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. No swapping. Okay. Then, next time, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. I'm just comparing 5 and 8. So, 5 is less than 8. So, they are in the correct order, so no swapping. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. I compared all the elements. Okay, so now I know that it is in the correct order. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. It is in the ascending order. It is sorted. How the algorithm will work? Okay, so algorithm actually goes for one more pass. Third pass. Okay, for third pass, this is the input. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8 is the input. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Okay. I'm just repeating the same procedure. First, comparing first two numbers. They are in the correct order. So, no swapping. So, no swapping. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. And let me compare next two numbers. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Let me compare 2 and 4. 2 is less than 4. So, no swapping. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Next time, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. I'm just comparing 4 and 5. 4 is less than 5, so it is in the correct order, so no swapping. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Okay. Next time, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Let me compare 5 and 8. Again, they are in the proper order. So, 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. So, how the algorithm knows when it has to stop means, for one complete pass, if there is no swapping, then the algorithm knows that, okay, the swapping has been done. So, it halts. Okay. So let me write that point. The algorithm needs one whole pass without any swapping, without any swap, to know it is sorted. Know it is. So we'll go for the Python code. Again, I'm telling it's not my code. I took the code from the internet. We'll try to understand the code. The code is very simple. I'll go for Python console. Okay. So I'm just writing a user defined function. Okay. Bubble underscore sort. So define is the keyword for defining the user defined function. We know that it should be terminated with colon. Okay, Later, if you see, I'm just calling this user defined function with some input ARR array. Okay, this is the input which needs to be sorted. Okay, so I have written a piece of code below that bubble sort function, bubble underscore sort function. So here, n, line number 4, n is nothing but it actually finds the length of the array. Okay, what is the total length of the array? Then you can see there are two for loops. Okay, one is for I, another one is for j. The first for loop is for the pass. Okay, whereas the second for loop, it is for the elements. Okay, it is for the elements. So I will explain this n and n minus I minus 1 later. So suppose here, if you see, I am just comparing jth array element with j plus 1. If j is greater than j plus 1, then a swapping is required. We know that the swapping is very simple in Python. Okay, and this is the assignment. So simultaneously, I am just assigning. When this condition is satisfied, when jth element is greater than j plus 1th element, then swapping is required. So what I am doing, I am just assigning j plus 1 element to j and jth element to j plus 1, swapping. Okay, very simple code, two for loops. Okay, then some if condition, that's it. Okay, then I am just feeding some input array ARR to this, and it prints the sorted array. Okay, it prints the sorted array. Let me explain this code. I will take this particular input and I will explain the code. So for the example, they took ARR is equal to array. Okay, this is the input array which needs to be sorted. 14 arrays, let me draw like this. 64 34 25 12 22 11 90. Okay, the indexes, we know that it starts from 0 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so the next one, you just see, I'm just finding n, where n is length of the array. So if you find out the length, it is actually 7. There are 7 elements. Okay, n is 7. So the first two for loop for I, okay, in range of n. So what it does, so range of n is 7. So I value starts from 0, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, it takes values, okay, 0 to 6. Basically, this is for pass, first pass, second pass, third pass, like that. Okay, see, this is not the optimized code, okay, even if the inner for loop is not doing any swapping option also, it goes for all the possible passes. Okay, then there is another for loop for j in range 0 comma n minus I minus 1. Okay, so n value is 7, n minus I. Now, okay, presently let me start with I equal to 0. Okay, I is 0, n is 7, otherwise I will write the whole thing. N minus I minus 1, n is 7, I is 0, okay, 1. So it's 6. Okay, it is 6. So j takes value from 0, okay, to 6, means that 6 is exclusive. Okay, the stop index is exclusive. So this comes to 6. So j is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So first we know that the inner for loop that will be executed. The next piece of code is if arr of j greater than arr of j plus 1. Okay, if this is true, then we are going to do the swapping arr of j comma arr of j plus 1 is equal to arr j plus 1 comma arr j. Okay, this is the additional benefit of the Python. Okay, the swapping is very simple. We don't want the third dummy variable, the dummy variable, it's not required. So we'll try to verify this code. So I equal to 0 is the first pass. Then I'll start with j equal to 0. Let me use other color. Okay, j equal to 0. So arr of 0 greater than arr of 1. Okay, so arr of 0 is 64 greater than arr 1, 34. Yes, the condition is true. So swapping is required. So I'm just writing arr of 0 is 34, arr 1 is 60. Okay, then again inner for loop that is incremented. Now j is 1. Okay, so now arr, when j is 1, arr 1 greater than arr. Okay, so now arr 1 is, the new arr 1 is 64 greater than arr 2, which is 25. The condition is true. So I'm just writing arr 1 is 25, arr 2 is 60. Okay, so now j is incremented, j value is 2. So I'm just comparing arr 2 with arr 3. So new arr 2 is 64, that is greater than arr 3, which is 12. The condition is true. So swapping occurs. So arr 2 is 12, arr 3 is 64. Again j is incremented, j is 3 now. Okay, so I'm just comparing arr 3 greater than arr 4. So the new arr 3 is 64, arr 4 is 22. Again the condition is true. So swapping occurs. So arr 3 is 22, arr 4 is 64. Okay, so j equal to 4, j is incremented. Again the comparison, arr 4 greater than arr 5. Arr 4 is 64, okay, arr 5 is 11. Again the condition is true. So the swapping occurs. So arr 4 is 11, okay, arr 5 is 64. So you just see the highest value of j is 5. Okay, so the last one, j equal to 5, I'm just comparing ARR5 with ARR6. Okay, suppose if J is equal to 6, what will happen? I'm going to compare 6th and 7th element. Okay, so there is no index 7, there is no index 7, so that will create error. That's why we are using n minus I minus 1. Okay, n minus I minus 1. So now ARR5 is 64 greater than ARR6. Okay, 6 is 90. The condition is not true. Okay, the condition is not true. So ARR5 is 64 as it is. Okay, ARR6 is 90. So once the inner for loop is over, we have, okay, after the first pass, we have the elements. Okay, so ARR6 is 90, 64, 5 is 64, then 4 is 11, then 3 is 22, 2 is 12, 22, 12, then 25, 30. So after the first pass, okay, after the first pass, this is the sorted one. This is not the complete sorted one. This is the sorted one. We will verify this. Okay, what I will do, I will go for the code. Instead of n, let me give 1. Okay, so it won't include the stop index. So I value is just 0. Okay. We'll see what happens. Let me execute. I'm just feeding the same array as the input. Let me execute. Okay, so we got a 34 25 12. Okay, then 22 11 64 90. Yeah, the first pass is working. Now in the same way, we need to take this as the input for the second pass, and okay, it should be executed. So now what happens? The outer for loop, okay, this I, that is incremented. Now the I value is 1. Okay, I value is 1. So J is again incremented. So let us try. I'm not going to completely solve the second pass. So now the I value is 1. J value, okay, J in range, okay, it starts from 0 and it goes n minus I minus 1. Okay, so which is n is 7, I is 1. Okay, so basically it's 5. So J value, okay, J value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So for the second pass, this should be the input. 34, 25, 12, 22, 11, 64, 19. Okay. So we'll just run the code. I'm not going to explain the second pass. In the same fashion, inner for loop for J equal to 0, you are going to compare these two, okay, and you are going to write the result. You are going to do swapping or no swapping. Okay, for the code, let me write this as n as usual. Okay, execute the code. You just see, this is the output: 11, 12, 22, 25, 34, 64, 90. Okay, the array is, the given array is sorted. And as I said earlier, this is actually, it is going for all possible processes. Okay, so but if you want to write your optimized code, this, if there is no swapping, if there is no swapping in the inner for loop, then you have to halt. Okay, in this video we have discussed a very simple code for bubble sorting. I hope you understood.